Hi, you are watching PDMS tutorial. In this lesson, we will learn how to rotate the nozzle and offset the nozzle. So, I want this nozzle to offset here. So, scene plan. Select this nozzle. And you can select by directly here. And just go to create copy offset. Here is it is showing x direction minus x, y minus y. So if we want here, so put positive value. Suppose I want 300 offset, number of copy 1, and just click apply. So here it is created, written created copy, yes, and then dismiss. So it will be created, but here it is a gap because it is exactly copy and offset through 300 distance. So we will select this nozzle and by down 100, by up 50. So here, and now we want to rotate this nozzle by 90 degree through this point. So first of all, go to create copy and rotate. Go to cursor element and just select the middle point. And now we want three copies, one here, one is here and one is here. So number of copy is 3, angle 90 degree, and it is direction already here is up, so we don't need to change. It is axis of rotation. So just click apply and retain created copy, yes, and then dismiss. So here it will be created like this. Suppose if you want to rotate or offset this nozzle, so just click this. If your cursor is not clicking here or selecting here, so just go to navigate to element and then click this. Go to create offset and here is a distance. So for upward it is Z. So just give it 0x and I want direction 300 in upward. So it will be created like this, but I don't want this copy. I will change this 500. Apply. Yes, if you want this on downward direction, sorry, first of all dismiss this and just click this and then go to create copy offset and give this minus and apply created copy. If I want to rotate this through 90 degree, number of copy 3, so just select this copy and after this select copy rotate and just look in a plan and select cursor element. I want this, so here it is not selecting. Yes, it is selected. After this I want number of copy 3 is through 90 degree and my center of rotation is upside, so here it is direction up and just click apply, yes, dismiss. So it will be created around the cylinder. If you want rotate more than a one nozzle, so just click one nozzle first and go to create copy rotate and we can apply directly, but here we want to rotate also this also, so it will be time consuming to rotate each and every nozzle. So just go here, sorry, go object, pick, and just apply this and click this and click this and escape. Yes, dismiss. So it will be created like this. You can rotate more than one nozzle or anything. If you want to rotate a single nozzle like this from vertical surface to 30 or 45 degree upward or downward direction, so first of all click this and don't go in create and rotate. If you go to this, it will create copies. So if you want to rotate a single nozzle, then go orientate and rotate. And if first of all go to cursor, select element. I am selecting this element, and this is upward direction. Look north side, look north side, and I am giving 45 degree, 30 degree, direction is up, axis is upward direction. But if we rotate upward direction, if our axis is upward direction, so it will be rotated like this, around this. We don't want to rotate around this, we want to it should be rotated in upward or in downward direction. So our axis should be in south side, and just click apply. Sorry, here it is created. So here is waist by waist 300. So it will be seam, and then by north 200, sorry, by east 200, by east minus 100, by east 50. So it will be seen like this. So here it is rotated through 90 degree. If you want it upside by, just up 200, so it will come like this. You can rotate any nozzle through this command and any of rotation, but you have to careful in which direction or which axis you have selected. So there is a no problem to rotate anything, but you have to imagine in which axis it is rotating. So if you like my videos, please like and subscribe.